Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome children to the second module of the lesson Useful Animals. Now we'll have a quick recap of what we learnt in the first module. We learnt about domestic animals. What are domestic animals, children? Domestic animals are animals which can live with human beings. Domesticated animals are grouped into two types: pet animals and farm animals. What are pet animals? Some animals are kept at home as pets. Example, dogs and cat. Farm animals. Some animals are reared in farms. They give us food and raw materials for clothing. Example, cows, ducks, hen and goats. Then we learnt about dairy farming and poultry farming. What is dairy farming? Rearing animals that give milk and milk products is called dairy farming. Poultry farming. What is poultry farming? Rearing of birds for their eggs and meat is called poultry farming. Then we learnt about how animals provide us clothing. In this module, we will learn about the other products obtained from animals. First comes the shoes, which is made out of snake skin. Next comes the lovely handbag. Next is the hair brushes. Now we will learn about leather. The skin of animals such as buffaloes, cows, camels and sheep is used to produce leather. When the animals like cow, goat and sheep die, their skin is removed and leather is made from them. How is leather made? The skin is first treated with chemicals such as tannin and later processed and polished to make it into leather. Leather is used to make shoes, bags, belts, wallets, jackets and suitcases. Next product we get from animals is the fur. Fur is the short, fine, soft hair of certain animals like rabbits, fox and squirrel. Can you observe that polar bear children having a thick fur to survive in the cold climate? The fur of these animals is used to make coats, caps and shawls. Squirrel's hair was earlier used to make the bristles of hair brushes and paint brushes. Now, this is not permitted by law. That means banned. What do you mean by banned, children? Not allowed by law to do something. Next, we will see about the horns. What do you observe in the picture, children? Rhinoceros with a strong, sturdy horn. What is a horn, children? A horn is a permanent pointed projection on the head of various animals that consists of a covering of keratin. Usually, we think horns are used for protection. Yes. Now, horns are even used to make ornaments. Now, we will see what are the products we get from horns of some animals. Horns of some animals are used to make ornaments, combs, knives and many decorative items. Can you observe that in the slide, children? Now, we are going to talk about elephants. Elephants are very huge and beautiful animals. They have two tusks which are very important, children. What do we get from the tusk of elephants? We get a product called ivory. Ivory, a highly valued product, is obtained from elephants. Ivory is used to make decorative articles. So they started killing elephants in large scale. To put an end to the large scale killing of elephants, governments all over the world have banned ivory trade. Now we will learn about how animal dung is useful to us. Animal dung is used to make manure. What do you mean by manure, children? Animal dung used for fertilizing land. Okay, so farmers use this manure to improve the fertility of soil and increase the yield of crops. How do we get this dung? The dung of some animals is used as manure. After harvest and before the next sowing, cows and sheep are allowed to graze on the farmland. Their dung makes the land fertile. In village, dried dung is also used as a fuel. Can you observe that cow dung cakes in the picture, children? Dung is also used to produce biogas. Biogas. Biogas is an important fuel that can be produced from cow dung. You can observe that process in the picture, children, how they are making biogas. Now we will talk about insects. Insects are also useful to us in many ways. Can you see the beautiful insects, children? Honeybee, ladybird beetle, and lark insect. What do you observe in the slide, children? Yes, the honeybees. Honeybees are very interesting and active insects. They live in a nest called beehive that consists of honeycombs. What is a honeycomb, children? Honeycombs are six-sided compartments wherein honey is stored in the upper part of the comb. A beehive is a home to about 50,000 bees. Bees produce honey, which is used as a sweetening agent and antiseptic. They also produce bee wax, which is used to make candles, cosmetics, and adhesives. Children, now we will talk about lark insects. Lark is obtained from lark insects. What do you mean by lark? Lark is a sticky substance secreted by the lark insect and used as a protective covering by the insect. This lark is very useful for us. How is it useful? Lark is used in India as skin cosmetic and also as a dye for wool and silk. Ladybird beetle. What do you observe in the picture, children? A tiny insect, ladybird beetle. It's very tiny, but it's very useful for farmers. How is it useful for farmers? It helps farmers by eating small insect found in the fields, such as aphids. What are aphids? Aphid is a very small insect, but it's very harmful to plants. So these ladybird beetles will eat off the aphids so that they prevent the damage to crops. Children, now we are going to see about animals for transport. Before automobiles were invented, people mostly used animals to move from one place to another. Animals like donkey and camel carry loads from one place to another. Camel. Camel are used mostly in deserts to draw carts. So a camel is called a ship of the desert. Why is it called the ship of the desert, children? Because it is adapted to live in hot and dry climate of a desert. Do you know something interesting about camels? A camel can drink 200 liters of water in just 3 minutes, and they can go for 10 months without even a sip of water as long as they get sufficient green vegetation and dew. Animals like buffalo, bullock and oxen are used to plow the fields. What do you mean by plowing, children? To dig and turn over a field before sowing, so that the land is ready to sow the seeds. So in such a way, animals even help human beings in their work. Children, we learnt about how animals are useful to us. They are useful to us in many ways. So they have to be taken proper care. We can't even imagine a life without animals. So we should take proper care of them. How can we care them? They should be provided with proper shelter, food and clean water. Their shelter should be cleaned regularly. They should have enough space to move around. They should be given proper medical care when they fall sick. Children, do you know to which doctor you will take when they are sick? It's a veterinary doctor or vet. So children, now we have completed the lesson, Useful Animals. We will see what all we learnt. Pets, dairy products and poultry, wool, silk, and then we learnt about the other products like leather, fur, and animal dung. Then we learnt about how animals are useful for transport, then plowing. So with this, we have completed the lesson, Useful Animals. Now, we'll have a simple assignment to check whether you have understood the concepts. Fill in the blanks. Dash is obtained from elephant tusks. Animal dung is used to make dash. Dash is an important fuel produced from cow dung. We get dash and dash from bees. Dash is a very small insect that is harmful to plants. So children, we have completed the full lesson, Useful Animals. So take your textbook and read it and try to solve the book back exercises. Thank you, children.